Someone just sent me a link to an article on the BBC website entitled, Two Slices of Ham a Day Will Increase Your Chances of Diabetes by 15%. And I thought, what? What? So I went and had a look at it, and it was actually an article about a column in the Guardian newspaper. So I went to the Guardian newspaper to look at that column, and it was saying the same thing, how eating meat increases your chance of diabetes, and quoting a research paper that appeared in the Lancet. So I went to the Lancet and I downloaded the research paper, and here it is, 11 pages of it. It's quite complicated science. I'm going to explain it in simple English. And in this video, I'm going to tell you why you don't need to worry about increased diabetes risk from eating red meat. Welcome to Shape Fixer. I am Andrew. I am a nutritionist. I eat plenty of meat. My risk of diabetes is very low because I don't eat sugar and I don't eat carbohydrates. I am not obese. My bloods are all fine. I'm not going to become diabetic from eating red meat, and neither are you. So what's all this fuss about? Well, this says, the name of this article is Meat Consumption and Incident Type 2 Diabetes. It is a study to determine if there is a link between eating red meat and diabetes. That's all it is. It's a study looking for a correlation. And we need to understand that if you do or do not find correlation, even when you do, that doesn't mean causation. Okay? The classic example is every time a house burns down, there's a fire truck parked outside the house. The fire truck is not causing the house to burn down. It's a correlation. It is not a causation. So, what's happening here? Over almost 2 million people were studied over many years to try and determine what link there is between red meat intake and diabetes. Now, there are enough problems even at the beginning with this study, because it was done, it's a meta-analysis of a lot of studies over a lot of countries, over a lot of time, and all the methods in the different countries were different. But for example, if you ask somebody right now to fill in a questionnaire and say how many grams of meat do they eat a day, and then you go away and you come back 20 years later to see if they have diabetes or not, whatever they said 20 years ago was what they thought on that one day. All sorts of things have changed in those 20 years in terms of what they eat or don't eat and their lifestyle, and it's really not very sound. But be that as it may, 2 million people is a lot, and you're probably going to get something useful out of it, and it would appear that there is a correlation between increased red meat consumption and diabetes. So if there's a correlation, does that mean there is a causation? Now, the implication in the Guardian newspaper and on the BBC website, of course, is yes, because that's what mainstream media does. They produce articles that are going to be controversial, that are going to get people talking, that are going to get them clicks on their site. It's irresponsible reporting because it's not very scientific. Nowhere in this paper does it say that this is proof that red meat causes diabetes. It is merely the fact that of all the people studied, those with diabetes on average ate more red meat than those without diabetes. Now, how can that be? Okay, first up, ham. Ham was quoted in the heading of the article, the headline of the article in the BBC. People who eat ham, generally speaking, eat it how? On bread, on a sandwich, with bread. So we know that bread, or increased bread intake, high carbohydrate, high on the glycemic index, massive contributor towards the development of diabetes, because we know what causes diabetes. It's insulin. It's high insulin levels, which are a result of high carbohydrate intake. So if you eat a lot of bread, you're going to produce more insulin and you're going to be at high risk of developing diabetes. The fact that you have a piece of ham on that bread is not the point. It's irrelevant. But most people who eat ham eat it with bread. Okay, that's the ham. Let's get to the real point here. Red meat. How is it that people with diabetes seem to be eating more red meat? That seems weird. It doesn't seem weird to me, because people with diabetes are insulin resistant, they're obese, they have eaten too much carbohydrate, they've been lied to, they've been misrepresented, they've been on the wrong diet, and their lifestyle has been incorrect. Obesity, lack of exercise, eating the wrong food, eating too much sugar, eating too many carbohydrates. People who are obese and who do not get exercise tend to possibly drink more alcohol, maybe they smoke, because exercise and health is less of an issue to them than people who really try to avoid diabetes by being slim, by eating correctly. And those people who worry about their health and actually take responsibility for it and sort out their obesity levels and sort out their blood sugar levels and cut down on their carbohydrates, focus more on exercise and being healthy, tend not to eat as much red meat, because we've been told for years and years and years, for decades, that red meat is bad for us. So those of us who are trying to be healthy and trying to keep our weight down and do then lower our risk of diabetes also happen to be eating less red meat. Now, that is a mistake, because red meat doesn't contribute to heart disease or to diabetes. We know that now, but for decades we didn't know that, and we thought that part of being healthy was to cut down on red meat. And so the people with diabetes are the people who did eat badly, probably didn't exercise, clearly were obese, because obesity is a marker for pre-diabetes, were eating red meat because they were eating sugar, they were eating carbohydrates, they were generally eating badly, which is why they ended up with diabetes. So yes, they had more red meat, they had more of everything, they were obese and they became diabetic. The people who avoided diabetes by controlling their weight and looking after their health and getting more exercise were eating less red meat because they thought that was a good idea. It was irrelevant, but they thought it was a good idea. So now you have the correlation between more meat and diabetes. It's got nothing to do with a causation. It's not a causative effect. And that is as much as they say in this article. It is just a correlation, not a cause. So if you have seen any articles in the mainstream media about this particular study, you don't need to worry. This study does not say that red meat causes diabetes. We know what causes diabetes. Sugar and carbohydrates cause diabetes. Thank you for watching, and please share this with somebody, anybody who's read this article and is maybe having a little bit of a panic about their red meat intake.